Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
In this video, we're going to go over the basics of sending and receiving email with Outlook 2010. The first thing you should do is make sure Mail is selected in the lower left, and we're going to start by creating a new email. In the Home tab, click the New Email command, and the Compose window will open. You'll need to add at least one recipient. You can do this by typing an email address in the To field, or if a contact is already in your address book, you can just start typing their name, and when you see their email address pop up, press the Enter key or the Tab key. You can also click To to open your address book. Then you can double-click a person's name to add them to the To field. Sometimes you may want to add someone to the CC or Carbon Copy field. You can do this by selecting their name and then clicking the CC button. Carbon Copy basically just lets the person know that they're not the main recipient while still keeping them in the loop. BCC or Blind Carbon Copy hides the recipient's email addresses from all of the other recipients. If you're sending out an email to a large group of people, you may want to put all of the recipients in the BCC field. But for this email, we don't need to use it. When you're done, click OK. Then type your subject and the body of your message. When you're done, click Send to send the email. To read your emails, you'll need to make sure Inbox is selected. Any unread messages will have the sender's name in bold, and you can click a message to read it, or you can use the arrow keys on your keyboard to switch between different messages. In this email, Gregory Mays is the main recipient, but Meredith Green also received a copy. It's a good idea to check this to see whether you're the main recipient, because if you're not, you may not need to respond to it. If there is an attachment, you can click on it to view it, or you can right-click it to print or save it. Now that I've read the message, I have the option of replying to it or forwarding it to someone else, and I'd like to reply to it. Since there was more than one recipient, I'm going to select Reply All so that everybody stays in the loop. I'll then type my message. I'd like to add an attachment to this email, so I'll click Attach File in the Message tab. I'll select the file that I want, and then click Insert. And before I send it, I'd also like to add a signature, which is a block of text that appears at the end of the email and usually includes your name and contact info. In the Message tab, click the Signature command, and then select Signatures. Click New, type the name that you want it to have, and then click OK. You can then type your signature below. You can add any formatting that you like, but keep in mind that if you're using Outlook at work, you may not want to use too much unusual formatting because it may start to look unprofessional. When you're done, click OK. Now, in the Message tab, click Signature and select your signature. Then click Send to send the email. And now, whenever you click the New Email button, your signature will appear at the end.